Before we start this video, I want to say a little disclaimer. One, all my opinions. This is just kind of my reaction to Clarence's video. Take everything I say with a grain of salt. Secondly, believe it or not, I'm not that good at talking in front of the camera or even commentating over something. I know that might come off as a surprise to some of you guys because I do have a YouTube channel, but yes, I'm not the best at it, and it is one of those skills I'm working on. What I'm trying to say and what I'm thinking don't always come out as I would like it to. I am putting myself out there, and I will continue to get better at it and become more articulate and increase my vocabulary, not just in my head.
Tell me all I see. I thought a bro nigga said something. Talking shit, but they still ain't saying nothing. We gon' trap this bitch out till the feds come.
Run it up. What she say?
I thought a pussy hoe said something. I go when I'm talking, you listen.
Jealous.
Cut her off cause she spoke on the business.
Go.
Hundreds and fifties. Can't swap a dime for a penny. You know that's a stupid decision.
Yep.
Head first with it. I shot a shot at my nigga, bitch. Really didn't think before I did it.
Nope.
Make it make sense.
Please.
Luckily, I was on.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to another video. I just pulled up to the gym. I'm about to go in there and start my clean and jerk training for the afternoon. Yesterday we had for our working sets, 5 triples at 120 kilos on snatch from the low block. So it was a very work heavy day, combining some front squat triples. Hands are kind of beat up, so it should be good. I'll make sure to stick around because I'm going to be giving my opinion on Clarence's video. Yeah, I'll be giving my opinion on it. So make sure to stick around and enjoy the video. Let's get into it.
So now I wanted to get into the whole reason of this video, the title of this video, kind of my thoughts on Clarence Kennedy's video. If you haven't seen it yet, I'm going to link it down below. Check it out. It's all about why he's against anti-doping efforts in sports. So, you know, like WADA, the World Anti-Doping Agency. I'm not going to get into too much in depth of the video. If you want to see the whole rundown, you guys can go watch it. Again, it's the link below. The first point he makes is that WADA and anti-doping's efforts are all about creating a level playing field, making sports fair, making them happy, you know, rainbows and sunshine. But in fact, he says they do quite the opposite. And I agree to an extent because, however, if there was no anti-doping, you would for sure have to pump yourself with gear to compete at a high level. And then it would turn into like a rat race for who can develop the best drugs, pump their athletes with the most of it. And then it would still be an unfair playing field to those who have invested the money and to the regions where there isn't an inherent negative culture around it, like the US. There's going to still be a bad connotation behind it. However, and also, I don't know if myself, I would want to be pumping myself with a bunch of gear, and then that's going to affect me for the rest of their life. If we're looking at in competition, these countries and these programs and these athletes, they know how to cycle off of stuff. They know that unless they're feeling a little risky, I'm pretty sure they know how to train with it so that their numbers are a lot higher in training. They could handle a little workload. They could handle a lot higher workload. They come off the gear and they're in competition. And they, if they were to piss, it would come back clean. But in fact, their whole training cycle, everything that they training leading up to this, they were on gear. So of course, that's going to play a huge role. They're not going to be lifting as much as what they were lifting on gear and training, but they're going to be doing substantially more than versus having no gear and not even be able to come close to that number. So I don't really think it's the in testing competition, even though that still can be a little, you know, sketch. I think it's more of the out of competition testing that needs to be fixed, the randomness of it. For an athlete like me, someone of my caliber, not that much is invested in me. So it's kind of impossible. Like if I got tested and I tested positive, it wouldn't just be swept under the rug. I would be suspended. And especially with COVID, the only time I could have seen myself getting away with it was COVID. There was probably an 8-month period where I was not tested. But if I come back to a competition, because I don't have the resources, I don't have the brains and smarts to cycle it, my piss would come back hot in a competition. So if anything, like it's still very unlikely. And even though there was that 8-month period where they didn't show up at all, one day they just showed up and then they kept showing up frequently after that. So it's kind of like, it's still a huge risk and I just would do not know when they're gonna show up. So it's kind of literally impossible for me to do. I don't have the resources, not that much is invested in me. So in that way, it does create an unlevel playing field. For example, guys, how are we supposed to compete with this kid who is 16 and now he's clean and jerking 1 kilo under the senior men's world record? I'm not saying the kid would not be gifted without drugs. He still would probably be doing 140, 170 as a 16-year-old, which is super impressive. And those are amazing numbers to have as a 16-year-old. However, I don't think he would be doing 160, whatever he did, and a 206 clean and jerk. And maybe he is just a genetic freak and the one. But coming out of Bulgaria, come on, like you have to, I don't know. It's just unlikely. The next point he makes is the flaws of the drug tests. Honestly, this part was super scientific and I do not know too much about this stuff. So I'm just gonna skip it. I'm not gonna speak on it. His other point was it creates corruptions. I agree with this because it's totally obvious. The countries that invest money in the sport can get away with it a lot easier than someone like the US or Canada or Great Britain, where they don't have as much money invested into the sport. Take example, track and field in the United States is a super popular sport. I know it's probably a lot easier for them to get away with stuff because of their close ties with USADA and the bunch of money and capital they have than it would be with USA weightlifting athletes to get away with stuff. However, I don't think there is just corruption because there's anti-doping. I think there is going to be corruption involved in high-level sports no matter what. Perfect example, the 2022 Winter Olympics are in Beijing. Guys, 2008 Summer Olympics were in Beijing. So I don't understand how the Winter Olympics are in Beijing. So there's some sort of obvious bias there. I don't know if I call it corruption, but just something's going under the table. So I agree with Clarence on these points on how anti-doping is stupid and doesn't work and kind of achieves the opposite. But I don't think there should just be no anti-doping efforts at all. What I'm saying is it just can't be what it is right now. Until we catch the countries and the people we know are facilitating all of this, this is just always going to continue. Until something super bad happens, like weightlifting gets kicked out of the Olympics, we have no worlds, just something crazy happens, I don't see these countries stopping at any point because it's just all they know. They don't know weightlifting without drugs. It's just unfathomable to them. At this rate, I do not want to see weightlifting out of the Olympics, and I don't want to see weightlifting split up into federations like powerlifting, where there's some clean federations and some dirty federations. It just might have to happen for anything to change.
Now, for conclusion, I wanted to talk about why I don't really like this video. It's not that I think Clarence did a bad job. I actually think it was a great video, and I think he's using his platform in a responsible way, shed light on a very important issue. The reason I don't like videos such as this one or documentaries like Icarus, although they are very eye-opening and important, at the same time, it's very disheartening and frustrating. It kind of brings that voice in the back of your head, is like, is just my hard work and dedication enough, or is it impossible? It's kind of that feeling when you discover Santa Claus isn't real anymore. It just kind of brings all those emotions to the surface again, especially when the three posters you have on your wall that you look up to, you know, all three of those guys had something to enhance the performance. Not only they had something to enhance the performance, they did something that you yourself are not allowed to take the step forward and do. How Clarence was saying that is also a reason why he doesn't compete is because he can't imagine competing for organizations such as the IWF and the Olympics, where everything is just so corrupt. And it really, again, just kills the romanticization of high level sports. And if you work super hard, you'll get to the top. And you know you're competing for something corrupt. So I know this might not be the smartest thing to do, but what I'm choosing to do is I'm just gonna act like I didn't hear it. These people are going to dope regardless if I'm allowed to dope or if I'm not. And again, it might be stupid. It might be me contributing to the whole naiveness of this image we have of high level sports. But as someone who's trying to make it to that point clean, I don't know what else to do. And you might think I'm delusional for thinking I'm going to get to that level. And you might think the odds are definitely against me, and which I'm not saying they aren't. But what I can tell you is when I started weightlifting and I wanted to take this more seriously, there was a lot of people who thought I was delusional for thinking I would be at where I am now and hitting the numbers I am hitting now. Although I'm nowhere where I want to be or where I think I could be, all I'm saying is this is nothing new, and this isn't gonna change anything I'm doing. Even good news, guys, you know Max Lang, good feeling he's natty. I'm pretty sure he's natty. Gold medal clean and jerk. Nino Pisolato won. I'm pretty sure the Italians are natural too. I don't know. I just have that vibe. Just have that natty vibe. Keep your heads up, my natty kings. Anyways, guys, thank you all for watching. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Keep your heads up, my natty kings. We got this. I will see you guys in the next video.
Huh? What? I thought a broke nigga said something. Talking shit, but they still ain't saying nothing. We gon' trap this bitch out till the feds come.
Run it up, run it up.
Huh?
What she say?
I thought a pussy hoe said something. I go when I'm talking, you listen.
Jealous.
Cut her off cause she spoke on the business.
Go.
Hundreds and fifties. Can't swap a dime for.